Okay, everyone can see the screen, right?
Yes.
Okay, one minute. Give me a minute. Shh. Okay guys, coming to the history of this Pegasus 7, it started in the year 1983 guys. Okay, so it started as a middleware tool. At the starting, it started as a middleware tool, and later they have done some modifications to the tool, and right now they are using as a development, and also we can also call as like a middleware tool also. It is inbuilt functionality. Okay, using this Pegasus BPM tool right now, we can develop any type of web applications. Okay, so it is application guys. Pega is one application, and using that application we can develop any type of web applications, and basically it is a Java based application. Means I can say this total Pega is developed and designed using the Java language. Okay, so this total Pega BPM tool is designed using the Java programming language. But don't worry, in order to learn this Pega tool, no need to have any prerequisites. Okay, so if you want to learn this Pega, means internally everything is inbuilt in the tool itself. Okay, so we will not write any coding, we will not do any, so no need to write any code, not even single line of code. Without writing any coding and without any prerequisites or any basic knowledge, anyone can learn this Pega tool. Okay, which is mainly used for developing web applications, and main domains will be finance, insurance, healthcare, banking, communications, media, okay, any type of life science, governments. So these are all the major domains. Okay, so the major market will be in these domains, and right now I can say healthcare and banking occupies the major domain. Okay, and the remaining domains, rest of the things. And coming to the Pega is also called as a PRPC tool, means Pega Rules Process Commander. Okay, what is this PRPC? See, we used to call it as a BPM. Okay, actually Pega comes under BPM category. Okay, under this, Pega is also called as a PRPC tool. Okay, it is a full name of Pega is Pega PRPC. Okay, we know Pega is nothing but a name given to the application. And what is this PRPC? Means Pega Rules Process Commander. Okay, so Pega Rules is a separate word and Process Commander is a separate word. Okay, actually this Pega PRPC is a PRPC is a platform for developing applications. Okay, so we used to develop applications, right, using this Pega tool internally. Okay, when you log into the Pega tool, it contains one platform in order to develop the things. Okay, that platform is nothing but a process commander. Okay, please guys, mute your microphones, recently joined people. Okay, everyone please mute your microphones guys. Vinayak, mute your microphone. Okay, thank you. Okay, internally Pega contains a platform for in order to develop the applications. Okay, that platform is nothing but a process commander. Okay, and what is Pega rules? Pega rules are nothing but, see, internally suppose if you want to develop a Java application, you require libraries and all the things, right, classes, everything. Similarly in Pega also, all those things, what are the inbuilt things we have in Pega, like classes, libraries, then functions, controls, methods. Okay, all these things we used to call as Pega rules. Okay, Pega internally contains so many things which is designed using a Java language. Okay, all those commonly we used to call as Pega rules. Okay, using those inbuilt rules and the process commander thing, process commander is a platform, combining all these things we can build and deploy any type of BPM applications, decision applications, management applications, okay, any type of web applications we can develop in this Pega PRPC tool. Okay, it is an application guys. Within this application we can build new applications without writing any coding. Okay, like it is a powerful tool in order to develop the applications. And the main thing is here everything is automated. Okay, you will not manually do anything by yourself. Everything is automated in Pega. Okay, so automatically it will generate the code in the backend. It will generate the HTML code in the backend. So what you have to do is drag and drop and point and click. Okay, the total design will be like all the options will be internally available in the tool. You have to drag and drop the things. Okay, all the controls and all the options are internally available in the tool. What you have to do is drag and drop and point and click. Okay, so using those functionalities internally, we can develop any type of web applications without writing any coding. Okay, so totally we can call Pega as a Pega PRPC tool. Okay, using this Pega PRPC tool, we can develop the applications without writing any coding. Okay, the next thing is, it is also called as a the build for change platform. Okay, yes, please mute microphones. Recently joined people, please mute your microphones. Yes, Nagamani, mute your microphone.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, Pega is the caption for, or the logo for the Pega, or caption we can say. The caption for the Pega is, it is a build for change platform. Okay, using this thing we can build faster the applications in a faster way with very ease, and it will increase the performance of the applications in a flexible way. Okay, like this everything internally contains, like all the features, like developing the applications faster, so with better performance, more security. Okay, and all the connectors are internally available in the tool. Okay, so everything is it is like a platform, guys. In that platform they have given everything to you. Okay, using those available resources, you will be developing the applications using this Pega PRPC tool. Okay, so it is a build for change platform where you can develop complex or advanced applications with a better, like a very easy, okay, in an easy way you can build the applications. Okay, so there is nothing coding part or anything will be there. Okay, within the tool only you can build the applications. And it is also called as a BPM, guys. Okay, then what is this BPM? Pega is also called as a, or Pega comes under BPM category. Okay, means business process management. Actually in other programming languages we'll use some methodologies like Scrum methodologies, Agile methodologies, right? Similarly, Pega internally contains a methodology called BPM. Okay, so this BPM is a methodology we have in the internally contains in the Pega PRPC tool. Okay, what this methodology do is it will manage the process and workflows in the organization. Okay, so the total process management will be like, so the total business flow will be managed by this BPM. Internally it contains internally, guys. Okay, the total overall flow of the application or overall flow of the business will be managed by this business process management tool. Okay, so it is like a methodology, guys, which is internally available in the tool. And the goal of this methodology is to increase the efficiency of the applications, performance of the applications, okay, and agility in the day-to-day operations of a business. Okay, and according to the Gartner, who is a top IT analyst, okay, he will give some ratings every year. Okay, according to him, this BPM is a management practice that provides for governance of business process environment toward the goal of improving the operations performance. Okay, so like he, according to him, he defined the BPM as, so it improves in performance, the like it helps in improving the performance of the applications, and also so manage the applications in a better way. Okay, so many advantages will be there. So like the work development time will reduce, the cost of productions will reduce, the number of errors at the time of designing the applications will reduce, security, performance. Okay, so like this, so many advantages are there using this BPM methodology. Okay, and Pega from starting it follows this methodology in order to develop the applications or in order to manage the process and the workflows in the organization. Okay, so this is the definition of a BPM, and Pega uses this BPM methodology. Okay, and what is business process? Okay, business process means, okay, it is also like managing the business within the application means, so all the planning will be done according to the planning, so everything will be connected internally. So like, see, if you take one application, so there will be connection between people to application, application to application, application to people. It's like a round process. Okay, so using this, what business process defines is, so it will create a connection between the individuals internally within the organization, and any third party of applications are available, so we can also connect to the third party applications. Look, so that is one total application, so where internally we can manage the connections within the application, within the business process. So when, for example, if you open any banking application, so you are the people, okay, you will be connecting to the application. So within the application, you will be have so many third party applications. Suppose if you go to payment site, so again internally it contains so many third party applications like this. So what this business process will do is, it will manage the process internally within the application. Okay, and it incorporates the planning of the application, designing, building, operating, maintaining and improving the business process in the application. Okay, so overall this is a methodology, guys, which helps in improving your performance and managing the total overall process of the workflows in the internally in the application. And there are some advantages of this BPM. Okay, these are all some of the advantages. Better applications we can build in a faster way. Okay, and process business critical activities faster with quality, reduce number of errors, exceptions. It will reduce the overall production costs. Okay, and reduce the duplications, increase efficiency, performance, security wise, and reduce the business risks. Okay, so these are some of the advantages if you use the BPM in the Pega PRPC tool. Okay, by default it is a methodology incorporated in the Pega applications. And some of the elements, so if you want to develop any application, so what are the different types of elements we used to combine, and how we can build the complex applications. Okay, here using this Pega, okay, it combines different things. Okay, if you want to design the forms in the application, you'll be designing user interfaces. Okay, if you want to write business logic, Pega internally contains so many rules will be there. Okay, so process is nothing but a workflow diagrams, data storage is nothing but a database, and integrations, Pega internally contains so many connectors and services. Okay, there is no need to manually configure anything. Internally, all the connectors and all the services are available. Using those available services and means the process is very easy here. When we compare with any other language or programming language, the process becomes very easy because by default you will get all the connectors and all the services within the tool. Okay, what you have to do is, you have to just pass the data, and for everything there will be some wizard will be there. Okay, suppose if you want to create a database, there will be wizard will be there. For creating the user interface, there will be some wizard will be there. For creating the integrations, you will have a wizard. Okay, for each and everything you will be having some separate wizard type will be there. Just you have to pass the data and just click on next, or you have to select the options in the drop down. So all these, combining all these things, we can build any type of complex applications. And why we go with the Pega? Okay, already we have some traditional programming languages out there, but what is the advantages moving to this Pega, and why the companies are switching to this Pega programming tool? Okay, so actually it is a product of a Java. Actually this total Pega is a designed using Java, and also in the backend it will produce the Java code. Okay, no need to, nothing to do with this backend code, guys. Just automatically it will generate the code. You can see, okay, no need to modify that or no need to change anything. Okay, just it is a Java based application, right? In the backend it will generate the Java code in the backend. And the main goal of this Pega, okay, the Pega system's main goal is to eliminate the coding and automate the manual work. Okay, so they want to, instead of writing the code and wasting time at the time of designing the applications, so they have designed such a tool like, so without writing the coding, all the options are given in the tool itself. Using those options, we can build complex applications. Okay, so automatically, so everything will be converted into whatever the format required to you. Okay, you can design complex applications. Okay, so complex web pages, business logic you can define. Okay, with what are the features you have in Pega, so those are sufficient to develop any complex systems within the Pega tool. And the core concept of Pega is, so change in the software with time. Okay, means, so what are the changes happening in the latest advanced technology? So Pega is one of the most advanced tool, guys. Okay, so we cannot compare this Pega with other BPM tools in the market. Okay, in the market you have so many BPM tools are there, but those BPM tools only perform very simple functions. We cannot develop the total web applications in that other BPM tools. I will tell you what are the some other BPM tools available in the market. I'll tell you. Okay, the main concept of the Pega is, okay, so overall goal is to, without writing any coding, how to develop the applications. And it also involves in cut down the cost of the applications, means the development time will be very less case. Okay, when we compare with, suppose, see, and one more thing I want to say is, what are the things you can do in Java, same thing we can do in Pega also. Okay, and what are the things you cannot do in Java, we cannot do in Pega. Okay, it is designed in such a way that what we can do in Java using the Java programming language, okay, all those things we can also develop in Pega also. Okay, so only one single tool, guys, which is a powerful tool, and using this tool only we can develop anything, any complex applications. All integrations also done. Okay, so right now Hadoop integrations, database integrations, SAP integrations, so Java, .NET, C. Okay, so it supports any type of integrations, guys. Okay, so for that all the connectors are inbuilt in the Pega, just you need to use those connectors. Okay, so the wizards will be there for you, for each and everything there will be some wizard will be there, you need to use those wizard. Okay, so it is one of the most powerful tool. Using this tool we can do anything which is, okay, we cannot say this is not possible in this Pega. Okay, so everything is possible and anything we can do using this Pega BPM tool. Okay, and some of the advantages of this Pega PRPC is, okay, builds solutions in a faster way, and it can, the Pega people will provide a, yes please guys, Ravinder, mute a microphone. Yes, Ravinder, make the microphone. Okay, thank you, guys. And advantages is, so they are providing a complete platform to you. Using that platform, you can build the applications in a smarter way. And internally, so you'll be containing different portals to access. Okay, you'll be working with a business analyst, you'll be working with lead system architect. Okay, you'll be working with some administrators. Okay, for all those things combinedly, so there will be some portal will be there. Okay, using, you can exchange the data in between the, means like you work together in a better way, in a smarter way, and build response and social applications and bring systems together, that is integration part, and join the community. So Pega is also contains some support center will be there, and any help you can, suppose at the time of developing the applications, if you need any support also, you can get the help from the Pega systems. Help centers will be there. Okay, so any query, if you mail to them, immediately you'll get the response. Okay, for example, if you don't know at this point, you don't know what to do. Okay, if you send a request to them, they will give all the required formats available. Okay, and Pega contains 6 stages will be there. Okay, so we used to call as, what are the 6 R's of BPM, Pega BPM. Okay, so in interviews they will ask these things. What are the 6 R's of Pega BPM means? Okay, receive. Okay, so normally they will receive the requirements. Business analyst will gather the requirements, like all the non-technical information he will collect, and he will route to the technical team. Okay, there the lead system architect will come, and he will assign the task to, based on the skill, he will divide the task into different parts, like, so different administrator team, database team, okay, and production team. Okay, and they will report, okay, what are the tasks assigned to them. So they will report what are the things we can generate in the application. So they will gather all the requirements, and then some research will be done. Okay, so recording that according to the application, some research will be done, and they will show it to the client. Some demo flows they will create, and they will respond to the client. Okay, when the approval gets from the client, they will start the production, and complete the application. Okay, so these are the different types of stages at the time of developing the application. So they will receive or route the task based on the skill, and they'll report the each and every team will be there. Database team will be there, production team will be there, testing team, quality team. Okay, so they will do some reports, analyze the data, and they'll do some research and respond to the client. Whenever they get the positive, means if the client agrees, they'll start the production and resolve the things, means they'll build the application. Okay, so these are all the 6 hours, means 6 hours of the Pega BPM. Okay, so this is an important question in interviews. In certifications also you'll get these questions. Okay, in theoretically these are the 6 hours: receive, route, reporting, responding, researching and resolving the work. So I'll share the required document to you, no need to worry. And in the Pega, in the market, you have so many BPM tools out there, guys. Okay, not only Pega is the only BPM tool, but I can say Pega is the number one BPM tool in the market, and we don't, right now we don't have any competition to this Pega BPM. Okay, it is one of the most advanced BPM tool, and we cannot compare with any other BPM tools in the market. Okay, so what are the features and what are the things we have in Pega, we don't have in other BPM tools. Okay, those are small BPM tools, guys. Okay, only some minor functionalities will be available. For example, and right now Microsoft and Oracle are trying to develop some advanced BPM tools, so they are in the process, they are on process, so they are still developing. But Pega is there from the year 1980s. Okay, so it is the most advanced, and so many features are integrated in the Pega. Okay, so for other BPM tools it will take so much time. Okay, and so many small tools will be there. IBM contains 50 to 60 BPM tools are there. Lombard is a BPM tool, Oracle, TIBCO, Appian, Cardis. Okay, so many other BPM tools are there, but Pega is the number one in the present market. And coming to the architecture of this Pega PRPC. Okay, if you want to work on, or if you want to install the Pega, so some operating system is required. Okay, it supports Windows, Linux and Unix operating systems, and one database is compulsory, right? So if you want to develop a web application, compulsory we require a database and application server. Okay, and Pega supports all the databases in the market. What are the databases available? Pega supports all the databases, and it is a Java based application. Automatically, so along with the Pega software, it will install the JDK also. Java JDK also it will install. Okay, so under this it is a development kit. Under that only we'll be working, means automatically. So everything in the backend is Pega. The total Pega tool is designed using Java. And I want to tell you one thing: the Pega 7 is designed using Pega 7 only. Pega only. Okay, what are the, I will show the tool. So what are the Pega 7 tool you are seeing? The total Pega is designed using the Pega and Java. They commonly use it Java also in some places, but so most of the part, 80% of the part is designed using the Pega only. And application server, okay, one application server is required, and Pega supports all the servers available in the market. Okay, like IBM WebSphere, Tomcat, WebLogic, JBoss. Okay, different servers based on the client requirement. They will choose the database and server, and they will take the license from the Pega system. Okay, so whenever they are working on any project, based on the requirement of the client, okay, based on the project, they will choose the database and the application server. Okay, so maximum Windows, they will work on Windows only, guys. So very rare cases they will go with other OS. So maximum 99% of the cases OS will be Windows only. Okay, and database, any database it will support. And coming to the frameworks, so Pega internally contains like a Pega own frameworks will be there, guys. Some thousands of frameworks will be there. Okay, we cannot name each framework. So how the framework will be there, means for example using the Pega some banking application is developed, means okay, so they will so what are the application they are developing? So they will save as one framework. So like that, Pega internally contains some thousands of frameworks will be there. For example, if that available framework is suiting your requirement, means the companies will purchase the framework from the Pega systems. For example, some Citibank is there. So for example, they are building another banking application. So 40% of the code will be same, right? So if you take any banking application, so 40 to 50% of the code will be, means the design will be same in all the banking applications. What they will do, so at the time of developing another banking application, so they will take the existing framework. Okay, for example, in the previously they have developed a Citibank, so directly they will take that framework and they will modify the instances. Okay, so and they will work on the implementation layer. Like this, Pega contains different types of layers will be there, framework layer and implementation layer, or they can also work on both framework and implementation layer. I will tell you about the layers later. Like this, Pega internally contains, so the most popular framework in Pega is CPM framework. Okay, CPM healthcare framework, and rest of the frameworks, so internally Pega contains so many frameworks will be there. They can use any type of the framework, means based on the requirement, based on the domain they are using, they can purchase the framework from the Pega systems. Okay, this is the architecture, guys. Under this architecture, we will be developing the applications. And when we compare with the previous versions, okay, 6.3 is the previous version, and so many changes has been done, guys. Right now, in the current version, the total look and feel is changed when we compare with the 6.3 version, and so many features are deprecated. Means some in Pega, everything is called as a rule. Okay, so many rules are deprecated here. Okay, in 7 version, so many rules are deprecated and so many new rules has been added in the Pega 7 version. Like in Pega 7, the some important things like cross browser, means Pega supports everything in the, means any browser we can open the Pega 7 tool. But in 6.3 case, maximum it supports Internet Explorer. Okay, and Pega contains some automatic dynamic user interface is the new thing added in Pega 7. Some new layouts has been introduced in Pega 7, and some warnings. Okay, there is something called warning edges has been added, and split schema. Okay, all these features maybe you cannot understand now. I'll tell you in the coming sessions. Okay, some pinned classes. For example, if you want to make any class as a, if you're using the class very frequently, so you can add to the pinned classes. Okay, zero downtime. So okay, even at the time of downtime, the server will not get down. Okay, so like, but in the previous versions, so whenever there is a upload or download is there, so they have to download, means the server automatically gets down. But in Pega 7, without getting the server down, they can take the process back, like batch process or schedule process. And application express is the new thing added in Pega 7. In previous versions we have application profiler, accelerator, but in Pega 7, okay, all those features are removed and everything is included in the application express. And there is a new concept called stages. Stages means we don't have in all the previous versions. So like, for example, stages is nothing but a collection of your data or collection of a flows in the application. Okay, each stage you can design the process. Okay, I'll tell you in later in detail. And there is a new concept called data pages. In the previous versions we used to call as declare pages. Okay, that rule is right now changed as data pages, and all the options, overall 80% of the options are modified in the Pega 7 version. Okay, so in Pega 6.3, so the total look and feel and all the options will be different, and in Pega 7 the total look and feel and all the 70% of the options will be newly added in the Pega 7. Okay, and automatically in Pega 7, if you design any application, automatically it will convert into mobile application also. Okay, so what are the, dynamically it will convert everything into mobile format also. Okay, like this, so many features are there. In detail I'll discuss later. And coming to the Pega versions, 7.1, 6.3, 6.2, SP1, SP2, 6.1, 5.5. Okay, these are some of the previous versions. And coming to the major changes happened, means from 6.1 to 6.2, major changes has been occurred. And 6.2 to 6.3, some 20% changes has been happened. And from 6.3 to 7.1, some around 60 to 70% of the changes has been occurred. Okay, so like this, so major right now 7.1 is the latest, and it contains some, like we can say 7.1.6 is the, okay, the code, overall code will be 7.1.6 or 7.1.7 or 8. Okay, don't worry, so those are just patches. 7.1.6 or 7.1.7 are both are same only. Okay, And for the installation of this Pega software, the basic system requirements required are, you can, okay, most of the cases install in Windows only, guys, Windows 7 or Windows 8 or Windows 8.1, and 64-bit operating system, and minimum RAM size is 4 GB, and minimum space required is 15 to 20 GB free space. Okay, so this is about the, so once again, anybody newly joined, once again, I'm giving the overview, just a quick overview of once again. So coming to the history of this Pega, it is started in the year 1983, and using the Pega we can develop any type of web applications. Okay, it is also called as a Pega Rules Process Commander. Pega is a PRPC tool, means Pega Rules Process Commander. It is nothing but a platform. PRP is nothing but a platform for building the applications. Okay, using this PRPC, so all the work will be automated. Okay, you will not do any manual programming, or you will manually do, you will not write any code here. Okay, everything is automated in Pega. Okay, so the total application development will be done in this process commander without writing any coding, and it is also called as a build for change platform. Okay, using this platform we can develop complex applications without writing, without any customization or without any complex thing. And it is also called as a BPM tool, and BPM is a methodology which is used to manage the process and workflows in the organization. And it is also called as a business process. Under the BPM, what is business process means, which will create a connection between the external systems and the individuals and the internal applications. Means within the application, if you want to create connections, means the business process will do in a better way. Okay, so it will manage the process, the and it will manage the workflows and manage the process within the application. And advantages, so these are some of the advantages. I will share the document, don't worry. And coming to the elements, okay, not only these elements, we will have so many things will be there: reports, notifications, okay, decision rules, business logics. Okay, so these are some of the few elements added here: user interface, business logic, process, data storage, integrations, reports. Okay, combining all these things we can develop applications. And it is a product of Java, guys. Okay, so it is, Pega is nothing but one application which is designed using Java programming language. Okay, and using this application we can develop any type of applications without writing any coding. And the main goal of the Pega is to eliminate the coding. And some of the advantages are, this Pega is, we can build applications in a faster way, and it contains a complete platform, and where we can build smarter applications along with the different teams. Okay, Pega contains different types of roles will be there, like administrator, business analyst, manager, okay, administrator, system architect, different roles will be there. Using or combining all those things, we can build the complex applications. And anybody ask what is the 6 hours of BPM, you can explain the chart here. Okay, I will share it with you. And in the market we will be having so many BPM tools are there. Okay, so when we compare Pega with any other BPM tool, it is one of the top BPM tool, and is the best BPM tool in the market. Okay, coming to the architecture, so these are the things. Using this architecture we can install the Pega. Okay, so it supports Windows majorly, any database, any application server, and it works on Java JDK. Like right now Pega 7 means 1.7. And some of the new features I'll cover in the coming sessions, new features. Okay, these are the versions in Pega. Okay, and coming to the so different types of roles in Pega, I want to say you, Pega contains different roles like administrator, manager, business analyst, okay, and system architect. Like this, these are builder, and also contains, okay, and for each and everyone there will be some portals will be there. Okay, but in 7.1 the business and analyst and manager portal is included into one, administrator and system architect portal is included into one portal. In the previous versions, how it will be like means, for administrator separate portal, system architect separate portal, manager separate portal will be there, and business analyst separate portal will be there. But right now in Pega 7 we have one portal for administrator and system architect, one portal for manager and business analyst, and one portal for user portal. Okay, overall we are having three types of portals are available in Pega 7.1 version. Okay. And Pega contains different types of editions are there. Okay, so if you want to install the Pega software in your system, you can install personal edition. It is also full edition, guys. It is a full-fledged edition. Once if you install the Pega software, you can work for lifetime. And another edition is enterprise edition. Okay, using that, okay, it is used in the real-time companies. Okay, so the server access they'll get from the Pega systems, but in the personal edition, no need to connect to any external server. You'll be working on internet server. Okay, so the Tomcat is the default server you'll get if you install the personal edition. But in the real time, okay, they have to purchase the license from the Pega systems and they'll get the access from the Pega systems. Okay, but coming to the options wise, all the options are same in both the editions. Okay, so what are the options we have in enterprise edition? Same options you'll get in personal edition also. Okay, so there is no difference in that. Only difference is in the personal edition, you'll get the default database and you'll get the default server. Okay, so apart from that, there is no difference between the both editions. And when you install the Pega software, I told right, it will install Java in the backend, one database, one application server. Okay, when you take the 7.1 version, JDK, Java JDK 1.6, sorry, 1.7, database it will install PostgreSQL SQL database, and coming to server it will install Tomcat. Okay, so these are the things it will install by default when you install the personal edition. It is a free license, free edition, free server only. Anytime you can install. Okay, it will work for a lifetime, guys. Okay, once you install the software, you can work for lifetime. And another thing is, okay, let me show the tool. After that I'll type the questions. Okay, if you want to log into the tool means you have to start the server. Okay, server will be internal in our system itself after installing the personal edition. Okay, already server is started in my system. Okay, it will take some 2 to 3 minutes to start this server. Once the server is started, you can click on login icon. Okay, Pega internally contains some default user ID. Administrator@pega.com. Password is install is the password. Click on login. I'll tell you the credentials in next session, another session. So everything is available within this tool, guys. Okay, no need to install any other tool separately. Okay, once if you install the Pega software, we can design everything within the tool itself. Even the database is internally available in the tool. Okay, even the reports generation, testing. Okay, everything. Okay, once the Pega software is installed, no need to install any other things. Okay, so all the design, everything will be done in the tool itself. Okay, so we'll be having all the things. Okay, right now Pega 7 contains different explorers. Okay, this is a designer studio we used to call. Okay, we'll have different wizards under this: data model wizard, okay, tables creation, reporting wizard, integration wizard. Okay, and if you want to build an application, means from here this is application menu, we can build the application. And if you launch to different portal, right now you are in the administrator or developer portal. Suppose if you want to launch any other portal, go to launch option. You can click on this, means it will go to the manager portal. Okay, and if you want to run your application, means from here you can run the application. And this is a search thing. If you want to search for any rule, you can search. And this is a application explorer. Okay, you will be having different explorers and this is a new design, guys. We don't have such design in previous version. Okay, all these things we don't have in the previous versions. Okay, right now, recent means under the, what are the recently opened things comes under recent explorer. Cases is a new concept added in Pega 7. Cases is nothing but a collection of different types of data. Means, see, you will be having different types of flows will be there, right? You will organize the data into different parts. All those things we can do from the cases category and data. Under the data category, so we'll create all the data pages. Okay, there is, this is also new concept in Pega 7. We don't have in previous versions. And if you want to build application from the application explorer, we'll be building the application. Okay, all the design will be done from the application explorer. Okay, this is a, some default classes. This is a default application. When you build your new application, you will get your class name here. Right click on that class, go to create option. So these are all the different categories. Okay, data model, decision, data model, all the properties, tables, everything related to that. Decision means all the conditions, integration connectors. Okay, all the connectors are internal available. Mapping, resources, integration services. Okay, process means all the structural design will be done. Validations, correspondence, notifications, service levels. Okay, from the reports category, reports generation, security, system admin, all the class creations, product rule set creations, database, external database connections, and technical category, all the methods creation, user interface category, all the form designing. Okay, like this, you'll be getting all the categories here. What are the rule you want to create? Just go to that particular rule. So, okay, any application you want to design. So this is the main explorer. Okay, from the application explorer, you will be designing the things and records. All the your application contain different records, right? It will display in some structured way. Okay, like a alphabetic order, it will display all your records. Private means, so what are the things you are working in Pega, which are the things under your control, all those things displays under the private category. Favorites means if you want to bookmark any rule, suppose you are frequently using that rule, if you want to bookmark that one, we can add in the favorites category. And this is also same thing only. So checkouts, anything under your private category, this is, and this is a recently opened. So already we have explorer here also, same thing given here. And Pega help, Pega internally contains a help files will be there, all the APIs. Okay, so total support, everything you'll get from the Pega 7 help. Okay, it is the best material, guys. You'll get the overall information about this Pega PRPC. Okay, for each and every topic they'll give in detail. So once if you install the software, automatically you'll get the Pega help option. And if you want to create a new application, you'll be adding the application from here. Suppose if you have access to multiple applications, means you can switch between the applications. Suppose at a time you are developing two applications. Okay, so we can switch between the applications. For building a new application, click on this new application and we can build the new applications. Okay, so overall in this tool only we can design complex applications without writing any code, and all the options will be available in the tool itself. Okay, this is the this is about the introduction, guys, Pega introduction. And coming to the overall sessions will be 35 hours. Okay, 35 hours session will take around 40 days, and you'll get the software from my set, some important materials you'll get. Okay, not important videos sessions you'll get, not all the videos, some important sessions videos will be there, you'll getting those videos, all the documents and certification dumps will not be there, but certification material will be given, because dumps means every time they will change, every month or every 1.5 month, 3 months, so the dumps will get changed. But you will get the material. What are the material? If you prepare that material, you can clear the certification. Pega contains different certification, CSA 7.1, CSSA 7.1. Okay, so different levels of certifications will be there. You can clear those certifications. Okay, so from my set, you'll get all these things. So resume preparation will be there. Okay, so anything from my set, you'll get all the support. Okay, now you can ask.